Today, my first question to you is, in this poem, Sea Fever, fever is the name of a disease or fever is a kind of desire? Disease or desire? What would be the answer? Tell me. Yes, students, it is desire. But now you have to tell, the desire is controllable or it is uncontrollable. So my simple question to you, the desire is controllable or uncontrollable? So boys, this uncontrollable desire or uncontrolled desire is called fever. And as the desire is for sea, so it is sea fever. So students, you can understand the name of the poem right now, isn't it so? Now, you have taken much time, probably time given to you is over, but you are not so flexible as I expected. So let us have those answers. Number one, she told Arnab that she had been bored. I repeat, she told Arnab that she had been bored. Next sentence. Let the doctor advise, the lady said. This is the sentence. The lady proposed that the doctor should be allowed to advise. Should be allowed to advise. Do not hate the COVID patients. Voice change. Here you can sense a moral obligation. There is a touch of morality here. So it is better to use should than let. So COVID patients should not be hated. COVID patients should not be hated. May God give you good sense. This is the sentence. All of you have done the mistake. Here I also wish, may God give you good sense. Now the answer is, may you be given good sense by God. May you be given good sense by God, or may good sense be given to you by God. Next. Mother often says that I was naughty when I was a child. Split. You need to know when you are breaking the sentence, you have to rearrange them. The sentence which should come first must be written first. Suppose the first sentence would be, I was a child. The second would be, I was naughty then. And the final sentence would be, mother often says it, or this. Mother often says it, or this. We should not tease a sleeping dog. Split. A dog is sleeping. We should not tease it. A dog is sleeping. We should not tease it. Or a dog sleeps. You can maintain the simple present tense because it is an idiom or a proverb. A dog sleeps, full stop. We should not tease it. Okay. Students, It is all but 1 p.m. So I would not take much time now. I am something to tell you right now. Just complete those sentences. Do not make hurry. Do the sentences sensibly. If you feel I will explain them on board, but right now let me say goodbye, because soon your Bengali class will be started, and this class will be taken over and taken care of by my good friend, your favorite KD sir. Thank you, goodbye. Students, my next question is, I must go down to the seas again. This line evokes or tells, I will tell three options: probability, possibility, and certainty. You have to choose one: probability, possibility, certainty. Which thing this line evokes? Students, my next question is, I must go down to the seas again. This line evokes or tells, I will tell three options: probability, possibility, and certainty. You have to choose one: probability, possibility, certainty. Which thing this line evokes? Indranil, Shovik, very good. And I admire you because you have read it and listened to the poem very well. I think others should do it immediately because it is a part of your lesson. And you know, actually the use of anaphora emphasizes the deep desire in the poet's heart. So you have to understand it. So Chobik, Indranil and others who have done it, but very few of you have listened to the audio, video. So you must be very careful. Very good. Right now, I will give you some sentences of grammar. The marks would be of 20, and you must do it on your exercise book by giving the numbers. For the rewrite, there are 12 sentences. For those 12 sentences, you will get 15 minutes, and there would be proper form of verb, article and preposition, and phrasal verb. Actually, you are reading poetry, you may get bored, but right now I want to do some grammar to break the boredom in you, to remove the monotony in you, and let us exercise today. Now face the question, boys. Yes, students, it is desire. But now you have to tell, the desire is controllable or it is uncontrollable. So my simple question to you, the desire is controllable or uncontrollable? Have you the exercise books with you and pen? Now you got silent because you have not read well, you have not listened well. This is the fact. Yes, boys, certainty would be the answer. Now, this line, I must go down to the seas again, can be seen in the first line of the first stanza, first line of the second stanza, and of course in the first line of the third stanza. Such repetition of a sentence is called something. What it is called, please tell me immediately. So boys, this uncontrollable desire or uncontrolled desire is called fever. And as the desire is for sea, so it is sea fever. So students, you can understand the name of the poem right now, isn't it? The next answer sheet forwarded by Sudipto. You have also done so many mistakes. Let me come to the point. Let me tell those answers. Now, you have taken much time. Probably time given to you is over, but you are not so flexible as I expected. So let us have those answers. Number one, she told Arnab that she had been bored. I repeat, she told Arnab that she had been bored. Next sentence. Let the doctor advise, the lady said. This is the sentence. The lady proposed that the doctor should be allowed to advise. That the doctor should be allowed to, or might be allowed to, should be allowed to, or might be allowed to advise. Do not hate the COVID patients. Voice change. Here you can sense a moral obligation. There is a touch of morality here. So it is better to use should than let. So COVID patients should not be hated. COVID patients should not be hated. May God give you good sense. This is the sentence. All of you have done the mistake. Here I also wish, may God give you good sense. Now the answer is, may you be given good sense by God. May you be given good sense by God, or may good sense be given to you by God. Next. Mother often says that I was naughty when I was a child. Split. You need to know when you are breaking the sentence, you have to rearrange them. The sentence which should come first must be written first. Suppose the first sentence would be I was a child. The second would be I was naughty then. And the final sentence would be mother often says it, or this. Mother often says it, or this. We should not tease a sleeping dog. Split. A dog is sleeping, we should not tease it. A dog is sleeping, we should not tease it. Athoba, sorry, or A dog sleeps. You can maintain the simple present tense because it is a idiom, it is an idiom or a proverb. A dog sleeps, full stop. We should not tease it. Okay?